بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك اللهم افتح علينا فتوح العارفين يا أرحم الراحمين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم We start today, we continue inshallah with our tafsir of juzʼ 30, 30th juzʼ and today inshallah we will be doing Surah al-Fajr and some other surahs. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله سبحانه وتعالى starts the surah with an oath and we've seen previously how what it means to start with an oath and I will just mention one more thing today that when an ayah starts with a waw most of the time this is the waw of oath we call it waw al-qasam So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing by al-fajr, wal-fajr. So what is so important about al-fajr, the dawn, the breaking light of in the morning when it advances? This is a blessed time. And we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears with blessed things, with magnificent things. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing with al-fajr. And we know that everything at that time has a special taste. Let's take Qur'an. When we read Qur'an at Fajr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ قُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ كَانَ مَشْهُودًا You feel the beauty of the Qur'an. Now no one is disturbing you. You are alone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at this blessed time. And you are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are reading His words. You are worshipping Him. So everything at this time of al-Fajr, at the time of the Fajr, all the worship has a special touch to your heart. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing by time now, by al-fajr. وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ الْلَيَالِ الْعَشْرِ are the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, which will, subhanAllah, they will start tomorrow. So what's the importance of these 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah? The 10th day of Dhul-Hijjah is يَوْمُ الْعِيدِ. So it's Eid. And Allah Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ الْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحُ أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ فِيهِنَّ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ الْعَشْرِ فَأَكْثِرُوا فِيهِنَّ مِنَ التَّهْلِيلِ وَالتَّحْمِيدِ وَالتَّكْبِيرِ So, there are no days in which righteous deeds are more beloved to Allah than these days. The days of Al-Ashr, the 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ لِرَبِّكُمْ فِي أَيَّامِ دَهْرِكُمْ لَنَفَحَاتِ أَلَا فَتَعَرَّضُوا لَهَا There are certain days and certain times of in your life that has special breezes. So use them and don't lose the great benefit in them. The deeds of these days are way much more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than if they were done in other days. And we know that, as I just mentioned, that Yawmu Arafah is the night The day when about which Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ما شهد مغفرة للعباد كما شهد يوم عرفة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive people on the day of Arafah. And Shaytan was not seen most humiliated except on the day of Arafah. And of course, we all fast this day before the day before Eid because of the amazing rewards that we will get of fasting it. So, wal fajr wal layalin ashr wal shaf'i wal watr. And Allah is also swearing by the even and the odd. What does this mean? If we take the day of Nahr, the day of sacrifice, is the 10th day of the Ashr. It's the 10, it's an even number. The day of Arafah is on the 9th, which is an odd number. This is one of the explanation. Another explanation is that prayer itself, when we pray, some of the prayers are odd, such as Maghrib, Witr, and others are Shafi', are even, which are the Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Isha. So these are the Shafi' wal Witr, the even and the odd. Wal-layli idha yasr. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also swearing by the night when it passes, when it goes away, and when the morning comes. So what's he swearing about? هَلْ فِي ذَلِكَ قَسَمٌ لِذِي حِجْرٍ. For those who have intellect and sound reasoning, isn't that the oath enough to convince them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to obey him? Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the ayahs after is going to mention the destruction of the people of Ad, Thamud, and Fir'aun. So he says, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَادِ. Haven't you seen how your Lord dealt with Ad? Ad, the people of Ad were very strong. They were tall people. They were rebellious. They were disobedient. They were arrogant. They were deniers of Allah's messengers. Allah destroyed them and made them legends to be spoken of and exemplary lessons of warning. So no matter how strong you are, if you are not obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, punishment. That's the result. So how did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroy them? وَأَمَّا عَادٌ فَأُهْلِكُوا بِرِيحٍ صَرْصَرٍ عَاتِيَةٍ سخرها عليهم سبع ليال وثمانية أيام حسوما فترى القوم فيها صرعا كأنهم أعجاز نخل خاوية. So for Ad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them with severe wind that were imposed on them seven nights and 8 days in succession. So the people were overthrown and they were hollow, as if they were hollow trunks of date palms, how hollow the trunk will be. So these are how they were. Iram ذات العماد. So Iram was the name they built. It was on pillars. This is another clarification of their city. It has pillars. So Iram is their city, and Ad were the strongest people of their time. They were the mightiest people in their time. So إِرَمَ ذَاتِ الْعِمَادِ أَلَّتِي لَمْ يُخْلَقْ مِثْلُهَا فِي الْبِلَادِ. The like of which, of this city, which were not created in land. It was a city in mountains. Then Allah moves to another example about the people who disbelieved. وَثَمُودَ الَّذِينَ جَابُوا الصَّخْرَ بِالْوَادِ. الْوَادِ is Wadi al-Qura, and those people, Thamud, are the people of Qawm Salih alayhi salam. What did they do? And Thamud, who cut the rocks in the valley. So they made pockets in the mountains, and they considered, they made them as their houses. They hewed great houses in the mountains. Again, they were not believers and they were destroyed. In Surah Al-Haqqa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about them, أُهْلِكُوا بِالطَّاغِيَةِ. The loud cry was their punishment. They were destroyed with it. A third example is about Fir'aun, وفرعون ذي الأوتاد. So, and Fir'aun with the Awtad. What's al-Awtad? Al-Awtad might be the armies who enforced Fir'aun's commands for him. This is one of the explanation of the word Awtad. And also they said, Awtad are the, Fir'aun used to nail people on pigs to kill them. And this is what he did to his wife to punish her when he knew that she was a believer. So what are these three examples? Those people, الَّذِينَ طَغَوْا فِي الْبِلَادِ فَأَكْثَرُوا فِيهَا الْفَسَادِ. Who, those who in land did transgress and beyond, they transgressed beyond bounds. They rebelled, they were arrogant. They went about making corruption in the land. So they harmed people. فَصَبَّ عَلَيْهِمْ رَبُّكَ سَوْطَ عَذَابٍ. So your Lord poured on them different kinds of severe torment. Remember that whoever is going up, one day will go down. Even if nature, if you are going up the road, you are up the hill, then on the summit, then you will go down. So everything will go up, will go down again. So they thought that they are undefeated. No, Allah defeated them. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَبِالْمِرْصَادِ. He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who created them, he watches over them. He knows whatever they do. He's not negligent to what they do. So no one will escape his punishment. He will bring them all before him and he will judge them with justice. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَبِالْمِرْصَادِ. فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانُ إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَأَكْرَمَهُ وَنَعَّمَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَكْرَمًا. As for man, when his Lord tries him by giving him honor and bounties, then he says, my Lord has honored me. So when someone would have wealth, good wife, amazing children, successful jobs, then he would say, oh, Allah is giving me this because he loves me. So he gets arrogant, he gets proud of himself. So this is wealth and honor. وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَهَانًا. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tries him by straightening his means of life, by restricting his provision, the person says, my Lord has humiliated me. So prevented me from having a good life. So his sustenance is low, his provision is low, so he starts to do some illegal actions to get some rizq. But Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنْ أَصَابَهُ شَرٌ صَبَرْ وَإِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ شَكَرْ. It's a wonder, the affair of the believer. If he gets something not good, then he would show patience. But if he gets something good, then he would thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in both cases, he thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not for the good things only, but also for the bad things, because he knows, he thanks him that the bad thing was not in his faith, it was not in his aqidah, in his iman, but in trivial things. So he thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when he gets something good, he thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because he remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَئِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. Whenever you make shukr, I will increase you in rewards and in bounties. So actually life is nothing but a test. Each and every one of us is tested differently. Health, wealth, death, different tests. كَلَّا بَلَّا تُكْرِمُونَ الْيَتِيمِ. No, it's not. It's not as what a person thinks. Look, someone, Allah gave him a lot, but what does he do? He doesn't fulfill the rights of Allah in the money, in the wealth he has. Allah gives who the believer and non-believer. And he prevents the believer and non-believer. So if one is wealthy, he should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if he is poor, he should practice patience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he should remember not to be of the category, كَلَّا بَلَّا تُكْرِمُونَ الْيَتِيمِ. So he gave him, Allah gave him wealth, but he doesn't give charity. So you do not treat, كَلَّا بَلَّا تُكْرِمُونَ الْيَتِيمِ. You are not good. You do not treat the orphans with kindness and generosity. You deprive them of their rights. You forget that أنا وكافل اليتيم كهاتين في الجنة, the guardians of the orphans and I will be like these two in paradise. And he puts his two fingers together, the middle and the index. He put them together. So you who get the health, the wealth, the everything, you do not treat the orphans in kindness and generosity. وَلَا تَحَاضُّونَ عَلَى طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينِ. And you do not encourage one another to feed the needy, the poor. So if Allah gives you wealth and you do not fulfill His rights in this wealth, you do not give, you do not feed people. So is this wealth that you have a ni'mah? Is it something that's good for you? Or is it a test that you failed? So in these two ayahs, we have a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be good to the orphans and to feed the poor and to be good with the needy people. وَتَأْكُلُونَ التُّرَاثَ أَكْلًا لَمَّا. And you consume inheritance with lawful, whether lawful or forbidden, unlawful. So you do not give the money of inheritance to those who deserve it. You get your share and the share of others, whether you deserve it or not. وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمًّا. And you love wealth with immense love. But did you perform, did you give, did you apply the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that wealth? كَلَّا إِذَا دُكَّتِ الْأَرْضُ دَكَّا دَكَّا. No. When the earth and the mountains will be flattened, they will be leveled, and they will be made even. And the creatures will rise from their graves and stand before their Lord. وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا. And when your Lord comes and the angels also come lined up in rows upon rows. وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ. Hell on that day is brought within sight. Hell will be dragged by angels. تُقَادُ جَهَنَّمُ بِسَبْعِينَ أَلْفَ زِمَامٍ يَجُرُّهَا عَلَى كُلِّ زِمَامٍ سَبْعُونَ أَلْفَ مَلَكٍ. Jahannam will be dragged by 70,000 reins, 70,000 bridles. Each bridle, each rein will be dragged by 70,000 angels. Imagine. So what will happen? يَوْمَ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانُ وَأَنَّا لَهُ الذِّكْرَى. On that day, man will remember. He will remember, I did not pray, I did not do good, I was not a good wife, I was not a good husband, I was not a good son or daughter, or I wasn't a good daughter-in-law, I wasn't a good father-in-law. But what good to him will be the remembrance? يقول يا ليتني قدمت لحياتي. He will say, alas, would I have provided good deeds for this life? He feels sorry, sorry that he missed doing more good deeds. He feels sorry for the act of disobedience he performed. فَيَوْمَئِذِ لَا يُعَذِّبُ عَذَابَهُ أَحَدٌ. On that day, none will punish as he will punish, as Allah will punish, severe punishment. وَلَا يُوثِقُ وَثَاقَهُ أَحَدٌ. And none will bind as he will bind. There is no one who is more severely punished and bound than those punished by al-Zabaniya, the angels of hell. Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will calm our hearts and he says, يَا أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْمُطْمَئِنَّةِ اِرْجِعِي إِلَى رَبِّكِ رَاضِيَةً مَرْضِيَةً. Oh, tranquil soul, come back to you, Lord, well-pleased and well-pleasing. I would take a moment here and talk about the levels of the soul. The first one is al-ammaratu bisu, the bad soul that will always order a person to do bad things. Then we have another level, al-nafsul lawwama, which we can say the conscious which is always alert. Why did you do that? Why did you do that? Why did you say that? Then we have al-nafsul mulhama. The nafsul mulhama wants to get the relation with Allah to be stronger. Then we have al-nafsul mutma'inna, the tranquil soul. Then we have al-nafsul radiya, the pleased soul. Then we have al-nafsul mardiya, then the soul which Allah is pleased with. And the highest rank is an-nafsul kamila. It knew the reality. Knew Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the real reality of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Felt the light of getting connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So surrendered to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completely. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling al-nafsul mutma'inna, the tranquil soul. Ya ayyatu al-nafsul mutma'inna, come back to you, Lord. Fadkhuli fi ibadi, enter amongst my servants. Wadkhuli jannati, and enter my paradise. This will be said at the time of death. And again on the day of judgment. We know that the starting point of the day of judgment is death. When a person dies, he knows where he will be on the day of judgment. So we move on, inshallah, to Surah Al-Balad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts with an oath again. لا أقسم بهذا البلد. I swear by this city, Mecca. So what is Mecca? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing with this place? It's the city that Ibrahim alayhi salam brought his wife and his suckling child to and left them there without any support. But he knows Allah is there for them. How he had built, Sayyidina Ibrahim, he built the house and he proclaimed to people to visit it. This is Mecca. How this city became a religious and commercial center for Arabia. This is Mecca. It's an important, a very important place that Allah is swearing with. وَأَنْتَ حِلٌّ بِهَذَا الْبَلَدِ, and you are resident of this sacred city. So time will come, as will become lawful for you to fight and kill the enemies of the true faith. This is a sacred city, and it will stay sacred. And you will free it from those who transgress in it. وَوَالِدٍ وَمَا وَلَدْ. Allah is also swearing by the begotten and that which he begot. And I swear by the father and the children he begot. The father here is Adam alayhi salam. So Allah is swearing by the mother of towns, Mecca, and by the dwellers therein, who is Adam and his children. What's Allah swearing about? لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدٍ. Verily, we have created man in toil, in hardship, in difficulty. His mother bears him with hardship, and she delivers him in hardship. And life is all full of tests. It's not a place for enjoyment. Man was not created here to enjoy himself and to live the life of ease and comfort. No. أَيَحْسَبُ أَن لَّن يَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ أَحَدٍ. Does he think that none can overcome him? Does man who is exposed to such hardship live in the illusion that there is no superior power to seize and suppress him? يَقُولُ أَهْلَكْتُ مَالَ اللُّبَدَةِ. He says, I have wasted wealth in abundance. And the word أَهْلَكْتُ here, الْإِهْلَاكُ الْإِنْفَاقُ بِالْمَعَاصِي. So he spends, but illawfully. He spends a lot of money on his desires. أَيَحْسَبُ أَنْ لَمْ يَرَهُ أَحَدٍ. He is proud. Does he think that none sees him? No one is watching him? Does he think that Allah does not see him of what he did? Well, nobody saw him, so he does so and so. He's alone. He doesn't know his deed. He doesn't know what he is doing. He doesn't know who he is disobeying. He doesn't know that Allah is overwatching him. He doesn't know that Allah has assigned angels, guardians, to calculate and to record, to register his deeds for him. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds him of the ni'am, of the good things that he has given him. أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ. Allah is reminding man of these bounties. Haven't we not made for him two eyes so he can see with them? If someone just gives you a big amount of money, millions of money, you will keep thanking that man, and you will keep remembering him, and you will keep mentioning him. Allah is giving you عينين, two eyes, ولسانا وشفتين, a tongue and two lips. So, doesn't he deserve to be thanked? Shouldn't you fulfill the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to your eyes? A believer should not look at something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited him of looking at. He should not say something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him not to say it. Should not gossip, should not say bad things, should not hurt people. وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ. And shown him the two ways, the good and the evil. We have opened before him the highways of good and evil, virtue and vice. So he chooses whichever he wants to follow. Will he be grateful or will he be an unbeliever? فَلَقْتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَةِ. Yet, he has not attempted to pass through the steep path, the sharp path. will he not traverse upon the path which contains salvation and good? The two paths, the virtue path, which leads to the heights, but this path is toilsome and steep. It is hard. This man has to go against the desires of the self and the temptations of the shaitan. But there is another path, which is easy. It descends down. Each sin makes the following sin easier and bigger. Once someone commits the first sin without repenting, then he keeps rolling down automatically. Shaitan will whisper for man to commit sins. The first sin that he will make, it will be so difficult to make it. But if he makes it and he does not fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he does not repent, he does not ask for forgiveness, does not do istighfar, then it will be easy to fall in other sins. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْعَقَبَةِ What do you know about this steep path? So this hard path. فَكُّ رَقَبَةً أَوْ إِطْعَامٌ فِي يَوْمٍ ذِي مَسْغَبَةٍ يَتِيمًا ذَا مَقْرَبَةٍ أَوْ مِسْكِينًا ذَا مَتْرَبَةٍ So it's freeing a neck. Something difficult, it's not easy. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, من أعتق رقبة مؤمنة أعتق الله بكل إرب أي عضو منها إربا منه من النار. Whoever frees a believing slave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will free for every limb of that slave, one of his limbs from fire. Sayyidina Umar says, سيدنا أعتق سيدنا. And he means Sayyidina Abu Bakr freed Sayyidina Bilal. Both are our masters. So, أو إطعام في يوم ذي مسغبة or giving food in a day of famine, in a day of hunger, in a day of starvation, during wartime, after war, people would be devastated. People will be so poor. Some very high rich people will become poor. يَتِيمًا ذَا مَقْرَبَةً So he should feed, he should give, he should be good to an orphan who is related, ذَا مَقْرَبَةً What does this relation mean? Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, الْأَقْرَبُونَ أَوْلَى بِالْمَعْرُوفِ If you want to give charity, give it to your related people, to your relatives. He also says, الصدقة على المسكين صدقة وعلى ذي الرحم اثنتان صدقة وصلة. Charity given to the poor person is counted as one charity. While if it's given to a relative, it's counted as two. It's counted as charity and connecting the ties. The ties of kinship. So if you want to give sadaqah, zakah, just look into your family before you give the sadaqah to someone who is far, to someone who is to a stranger. أو مسكيناً ذا متربة and give and be good to a poor person, a miserable person and who is clinging to the dirt. A person who is poor, who has no house or anything to protect him against the dirt. ثُمَّ كَانَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا Along with these beautiful characteristics, he was a believer in his heart, seeking the reward of Allah, seeking the reward only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْمَرْحَمَةِ So he was a believer and he recommended people who are believers recommend one another to be patient and recommend one another to merciful compassions, to merciful actions. He was from the believers who did righteous deeds and be merciful to other people. There are a lot of narrations by Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to talk about being merciful to others. He says, "Al-Rahimuna yarhamhumur Rahman." Irhamu man fil ard, yarhamkum man fil sama. The merciful people will be treated with mercy by the most merciful. Be merciful to those who are on earth, and he who is above the heavens will be merciful to you. In another narration, he says, لا يرحم الله من لا يرحم الناس. Allah will not be merciful with whoever is not merciful with people. Because those good people, أولئك أصحاب الميمنة, they are the people of the right hand. They are the winners who will get their records with their right hands. But والذين كفروا بآياتنا هم أصحاب المشأمة, but those who disbelieved in our revelation, those who denied, are the people of the left hand. Those are the losers who would get their records with their left hands. عليهم نار مؤصدة. They shall have fire enveloping them. It will be sealed over them. And there will be no way for them to avoid it. Nor they will have any way out. The torment will not end. It will not even decrease. It's مُؤْصَدَ عَلَيْهِمْ نَارٌ مُؤْصَدَ مُؤْصَدَ. The doors will be closed and there will be no escape. There will not be any way out. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of the winners who receive the records in their right hand, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with. And they are pleased with the bounties that Allah has prepared for them. In Surah Al-Shams, there is something that calls for attention at the end of each of the ayahs of the surah, of this surah, and it's dhiha at the end. So when we listen to Surah Al-Shams, this ha attracts our attention. والشمس وضحاها والقمر إذا تلاها والنهار إذا جلاها والليل إذا يغشاها. All the ayahs end with ha at the end. So there is this ha calls for our attention, and it tells us that there is a secret to each of Allah's creation, which we are going to read about. وَالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا. Again, Allah is swearing, Allah is giving an oath by the sun and its light, its brightness. وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا تَلَاهَا. And by the moon as it follows the sun. وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا. And by the day when it illuminates. وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَاهَا. And by the night when it covers up the sun. وَالسَّمَاءِ وَمَا بَنَاهَا. And by the heaven and its constructor. Allah has raised the skies and perfected it. Nothing is holding the skies in place. So Allah is swearing also by the skies. وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا طَحَاهَا. And by the earth and who spreads it. And by what Allah has created in the earth. وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا. And he created the soul. He created and he proportioned everything that he has created. He created the soul, and that was on the correct nature. So Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, كُلُّ مَوْلُودٍ يُولَدُ عَلَى الْفِطْرَةِ فَأَبَوَاهُ يُهَوِّدَانِهِ أَوْ يُمَجِّسَانِهِ أَوْ يُنَصِّرَانِهِ. Each child, each infant is born upon the right nature, fitra. But his parents make him a Jew, Christian, a Zoroastrian. So, but the first creation is on fitra, on the correct nature, on the right nature. فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. Allah showed the nafs, Allah showed people its good and its evil. So Allah is swearing, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. Indeed, he succeeds who purifies himself. Who purifies himself by obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he will be successful. He cleanses himself from the lowly and despicable characteristics, so he is successful. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. So this is the other thing that Allah has sworn to, that he fails who suppressed it. He's a loser who spent his time disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma aati nafsi taqwaha anta waliyuha wa mawlaha wa khayru man zakkaha. Oh Allah, give my soul its good. You are the guardian and the master. You are the best to purify it. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give us examples. An example about the people of Sayyidina Salih, Thamud. He says, كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ بِطَغْوَاهَا. Thamud denied through their transgression. So what happened to Thamud? The people of Thamud challenged their prophet Salih to present a sign, a miracle, to show that he is a truthful messenger, that he is truthful, that he is not just claiming to be a prophet. So, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah answered his call, and he said, there will be a she-camel coming out of this mountain, so you will not harm this she-camel. It will graze wherever it wants, it will drink from the water one day, and the whole tribe will drink the other day. So he told them that this is a blessed she camel. But what did they do? They did not listen, and they assigned one of their leaders, whose name was Qudar ibn Salif, and idin ba'atha ashqaha. He was the most wretched. He rose up and he wanted to kill, and he killed that she camel. فنادوا صاحبهم فتعاطى فعقر. So this is in Surah Al-Qamar in Ayah 29. They called their companion, and he took a sword and killed this she camel. فقال لهم رسول الله ناقة الله وسقياها. So the messenger warned them, don't do anything bad to it. This is a sign from Allah, but they did not listen. فَكَذَّبُوهُ فَعَقَرُوهَا. So they denied him, and they killed this she-camel. And they said, okay, bring the scourge. They challenged him. So he said, okay, you will have 3 more days to enjoy your lives, but then you will have the punishment. فَكَذَّبُوهُ فَعَقَرُوهَا فَدَمْدَمَ عَلَيْهِمْ رَبُّهُمْ بِدَنْبِهِمْ فَسَوَّاهَا. So he made the punishment descend upon them, and Allah destroyed them all. And he destroyed them, we just mentioned that he destroyed them, أُهْلِكُوا بِالطَّاغِيَةِ, with a loud cry. وَلَا يَخَافُ عُقْبَاهَا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he feared not the consequences. Any king, any ruler, he would think of the consequences of any action he wants to take against his people. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah's power is supreme. He will not think of anything. He will give the order, and no one will question Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-Layl, the next surah, Allah is also swearing. He is swearing to the diversity of mankind in their efforts. وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَى. By the night as it envelops. When it comes, everything becomes dark. It comes with darkness. وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا تَجَلَّى. And by the day as it appears. During night, life will calm down. And during day, life will go back. Life will start again. وَمَا خَلَقَ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى. And by him, Allah, who created male and female. We have created you in pairs. This is what he says in Surah An-Naba. وَخَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. وَمَا خَلَقَ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى. The male and the female. So Allah is swearing, إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَدَّ. Certainly your efforts and deeds are in diverse. The actions of people are not the same. They differ. Some people do good, some people do bad. Some people are good, some people are evil. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى. As for him who gives and fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his actions, he has taqwa in his heart. وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى. And believes in the compensation for that. He believes in good and he believes that the reward will be from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى. For him we shall facilitate the path of goodness. So this one, this person has taqwa in his heart. When you have taqwa, when you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you know that he is overwatching, then you will feel ashamed of doing something bad, of doing something evil. You don't want Allah to be upset with you. وَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلَ وَاسْتَغْنَى. But he who refrains from spending for the sake of Allah, he who is greedy, he who is stingy, who doesn't want his wealth to decrease, or if he spends for to gain reputation or to obtain some benefits and gains. He thinks that he is self-sufficient. He doesn't need the reward from Allah. He just wants the fame. وَكَذَّبَ بِالْحُسْنَى. And he denies goodness. He belies. He denies the compensation that Allah has prepared for him, for those who give. فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى. We will make smooth for him the path to evil. وَمَا يُغْنِي عَنْهُ مَالُهُ إِذَا تَرَدَّى. And what will his wealth avail him when he perishes? لَن تُغْنِيَ عَنْهُمْ أَمْوَالُهُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا. When he dies, what good will their wealth and children do for them? Nothing. They will not veil them from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one will help him when he is in fire. إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا لِلْهُدَى. Truly, it's for us to gain guidance, to give guidance, to give guidance so people will gain it. You do not, إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتُ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. If you want to guide someone, you love that person, but if Allah doesn't want the hidayah for him, then he will not be guided. This is why we keep repeating in our du'as, Allahumma hdina fi man hadayt. Ya Allah, make us of the people whom you guided. Inna alayna lalhuda, wa inna lana lalakhirata wal-ula. And indeed, ours is the hereafter and this world also. It's for both belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who is in complete control of them. فَأَنْذَرْتُكُمْ نَارًا تَلَظَّى. Therefore, I have warned you of a blazing fire. Blazing fire. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in one of the narrations, إِنَّ أَهْوَنَ أَهْلِ النَّارِ عَذَابًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ رَجُلٌ يُوضَعُ فِي أَخْمَصِ قَدَمَيْهِ جَمْرَتَانِ يَغْلِي مِنْهُمَا دِمَاغُ. So the easiest the lightest punishment of the people of fire on the day of judgment will be a man whom two coals have been placed on the bottom of his feet that will cause his brain to boil. فَأَنْذَرْتُكُمْ نَارًا تَلَظَّى لَا يَصْلَاهَا إِلَّا الْأَشْقَى. None shall enter this fire save the most wretched. الَّذِي كَذَّبَ وَتَوَلَّى. Who denied and who turned away. Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says, كُلُّ أُمَّةِ يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَبَى. Everyone will enter paradise except who denies. So they asked, Ya Allah, who are those people who refuse to enter Jannah? And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Man ata'ani dakhala al-jannah wa man asani faqad aba. Whoever obeys me will enter paradise, and whoever disobeys me, then he has refused. وسيجنبها الأتقى الذي يؤتي ماله يتزكى وما لأحد عنده من نعمة تجزى إلا ابتغاء وجه ربه الأعلى وسوف يرضى. These are the most deserving of the a person of the Ummah is Sayyidina Abu Bakr, whom these ayahs are honoring him. سيجنبها الأتقى. The righteous, pure, most pious person will be saved from fire. الذي يؤتي ماله يتزكى. He who gives his wealth for self-purification. His intention is to purify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to purify his money. It's not for pure reputation. It's not for fame. It's sincere intention. وَمَا لِأَحَدٍ عِنْدَهُ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ تُجْزَى. And he received no favor from anyone for which he has to return a reward. إِلَّا ابْتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِ الْأَعْلَى. Except to seek the face of his Lord. This is his intention. Just to gain the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He does everything for the sake of Allah, to get rewarded from him and not from any other person, not for any other reason. He does everything in obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hoping to attain the blessing of seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in paradise. وَلَسَوْفَ يَرْضَى. And he will surely be well pleased of the bounties that Allah has prepared for him. Ya Allah, make our intentions pure, all pure for your sake, Ya Allah. Make us of the winners whom you love and whom you will be pleased of. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.